Hello, Alta Labs fans. Jeff Hansen here, and today we are going to talk about a new feature we call real-time logs. Now, with this feature, you can look at the real-time logs from all of the Alta Labs devices on your network. You can even search for a particular string and be notified when that string pops up in any of the devices on your entire network. So, I'm going to show you how to use it real quick here. You go up here to the Events button up here. This is where you'll get notified about various events that happen on your system. And then you go to the Logs button here. This will pop up a window where you can search for a particular event. So let's say we want to look up all disassociate events on the network. What this does is it sends out a request to all the devices on the network and looks for anything that matches this string that you typed in. And it'll sort them by timestamp. This is all to the millisecond granularity. And then if anything else comes in while this is spinning, you'll also see that come in the logs at the very top. So you can actually view what's going on your network in real time. This also has the feature of regex. So if you know how to use regular expressions, you can search for example, let's look for either disconnect or disassociate. And then it's going to go ahead and grab that from all of the access points, switches, and routers that are on the network. So you can see here we have a lot of disassociated. If we keep going, we'll see there's some disconnects here. And so if you're trying to debug a problem, it makes it really easy in real time. And this gives you all of the information that the device itself has, as far as logs go on each device, to debug and figure out what's going on. You can mark particular entries by clicking on them. Let's say there's an important entry that you want to go back and look at later. You can mark them. You can also just download the logs. So let's stop receiving logs, and then we can just hit this button right here. And it will download everything that's in this list, and it'll download it straight to your computer. So you can import that into something else and do further analysis if you like. Another really cool feature that we have that's part of this real-time logs is you can take a look at specific devices. So let's say you're having a problem with a specific device on your network that keeps reconnecting or something like that. So if you want to look at all of the logs that are related to that specific device, you go to the Info tab on that device's device card right here. And then you can see here's the MAC address. What that will do is when I click on this, it'll open up a logs window and automatically populate it with the MAC address of that device. And so we can see in real time that this device most recently connected to the guest room device right here, the guest room access point. You can see how it's connecting WPA pairwise, so it's PSK. You can see that it made a request to the router right here. And so you can see all of that in this tab. And so yeah, you can go back and review, you know, if you're having a problem or an issue, what's going on there. Another thing to note about this feature is by default, you know, Alta Labs devices don't store a ton of data in their logs. It's about 600 kilobytes of logs, which is about, you know, enough for a few hours typically. So if you want to actually do more, you can go to your settings, you go to system, and let's say you're trying to debug a problem that happens once a day or even once a week. You'll want to go in here to settings. Go into System, go down to Advanced, and you go in here and you can look at the persistent logging option right here. Now, these are different settings for APs, routers, and switches because they are different kinds of devices, and each one has different amount of storage on each one. APs and routers have eMMC flash, so they have tons of storage. The switches have NOR flash or NAND on some of the newer ones, and so they don't have quite as much storage. So that's why you'll want to make sure you do a little bit different tuning for each one. And you'll have to play with this to figure out exactly how much to increase it if you're trying to debug a specific problem. But typically, you know, if you set it to like 5 megabytes, that would be plenty for a few days at least on APs. Routers have a lot more traffic, so you may want to increase it a little bit more than that if you're trying to isolate something that happens once a week. And then switches, generally, you know, they don't have a ton of logs, so since they're, you know, pretty sporadic in what they log and they don't log a ton, usually you can do a little bit lower logs. But you come in here and you set that option, and then from then on out, once this option is set on your site, all of the APs will enable that 1 megabyte or 2 megabytes of logging per device, and it will be stored in persistent storage on the device. So let's say you reboot the APs or the router or the switch, that log would be maintained through a reboot. And so you don't have to worry about rebooting, you know, losing any of your information in your logs. So that's a way to, you know, turn on the logs if you're debugging something that happens that, you know, you can't isolate within the last 5 minutes or hour. You'll want to come in here and turn on persistent logging so you can capture those events. And then you come back to the logs up here and you can search for that specific thing. You can also just search for everything. Let's say you want to just see everything that's happening on your network. This will tell you as events come in, you know, everything that's coming into the network. So it can be pretty verbose, but it will allow you to download all of the logs from all of your devices, get a snapshot of that if you like. So we're really excited about this feature. Hope you are too. If you have any questions, please ask them on forum.alta.inc. And thanks for watching.